Hey, horse people. This is pretty funny. These two horses are pretty cute in this scene. The two actors are trying to do their, and somebody said this from The Duelist, I think, 1977 or something. But anyway, these two little white horses are having their own little conversation and their own little, their own little love affair while this dude is trying to have a love affair with her. And when they end up kissing, the horses end up kissing behind them. It's pretty funny. But I want you to watch, of course, they have huge bits on, and this guy is constantly tugging on the bit. He's probably, they may have taken this a few times or taken his cuts. He's probably trying to keep the horses apart, but he's really using this bit and keeping his hand close to this bit and kind of yanking on his horse and frustrating him. And these two little horses are just like, hey, man, this guy smells this horse. This horse tells him back up. And then they're smelling each other's noses. It's pretty funny. Check this out.
If I were to neglect to make your proposal, no blame would attach to you. I think perhaps you might be saved from a sad adult life.
You see this horse sneaking in to get a smell back here? See this horse saying, hey, you better get back. See her not paying attention to her horse and giving him a long lead. These actors so totally set these horses up to fail, and they fail.
If you neglect to make me a proposal, my uncle will go mad.
See, neither one of them are horse people, so she doesn't even realize this horse is invading, and this horse saying, hey, this horse is trying to sniff my pee-pee. Get back. You better get this horse away from me. So he's trying to tell the stupid human, but he's so busy hanging onto the bit, he doesn't realize the horse is warning him that this horse is encroaching and bugging him.
Damn, put on this earth to coddle your uncle.
So the horse says, hey, I told you to get back. And then this guy yanks on his bit again.
Damn, put on this earth to coddle your uncle.
Watch his leg. He thinks he's about
to
get
kicked. Put on this earth to coddle your uncle.
I have heard you do swear most terribly.
Nonsense.
So now she gathers up her reins, tries to keep her horse away. He's trying to keep his horse away. The horses have given themselves distance.
Tempered man. Tempered in my speech. I love you.
I can't tell if she's laughing at the horses or the scene or if this is part of the script and he's staying in part. But this horse's ears, now they're facing each other. I mean, these horses are kind of, look, they probably weren't allowed to play with each other. If somebody was doing this right, these two horses would have been kept in a open round pen or something to where they could get all their piss and vinegar out. They could play, they could indoctrinate, they could get used to each other, and then they would be saddled up and brought out to the scene when all that was out of them. Instead, they probably keep them separate. They keep them locked up in these little cages. They don't, you know, they don't want them sweaty. They don't want them dirty, so they've had to braid their mane and keep them all pretty. And then they come out here with all this piss and vinegar, and they wonder why the horses want to be horses and socialize with other horses. The horses are being totally normal.
Adele.
This horse starts cleaning his. I don't have a problem with this. This guy is doing pretty good at ignoring him. I just don't like the way he keeps yanking on his bit to control him. If he didn't have a bit and he just had a rope halter, he could do the same thing without causing pain. That metal in a horse's mouth is pain. Come on, people. Quit trying to lie and justify it. It doesn't hurt and a horse likes it. All that other crazy nonsense. So the horse almost knocked him down. He goes down on one knee, and now when they kiss, the two horses kiss too.
My dearest Adele, it would make me very happy. Happy beyond all expectation if you would do me the honor to become my wife.
Yes.
Hey, when you're working with animals and horses, they're always going to have bloopers. Horses are going to do their own thing. Things are going to happen. Of course, none of the people, the actors that work with horses, are truly horse people. They may own a horse. They may say, I've ridden. They may have a room full of pink ribbons that they won when they were a kid. They may have pictures of them riding a Walmart horse for a quarter, but they're not horse people. They're not horsemen. So, you know, you're going to run into problems when you put non-horse people trying to work horses in a controlled scene environment and expect everything to go good. I thought this was kind of funny. We'll end that there.